So my name is Katie Benson. I'm a PhD student in the program in molecular medicine at Boston University, and I work in Daryl Cotton's lab at the Center for Regenerative Medicine here on the Boston University Medical Campus. Okay, so basically what I'm interested in is trying to understand the signals that regulate lung development. So I'm really interested in the cells that make up your airways. And what I'm trying to understand is basically how these cells decide what to be. So in your airways, there's lots of different types of cells. There's ciliated cells, which help push debris and things that you inhale out of your lungs. There's what we call secretory cells that secrete proteins and things that help to protect your lungs. And there's lots of different types of cells. And what I'm interested in is how these cells decide what to be during development. And that's important because in a lot of diseases like COPD, basically what happens is that these cells over your lifetime have gotten a lot of damage from, like, for instance, if you smoke or even just inhaling the things that are in the air. So your lungs are sort of made to deal with inhaling these things, but over time they sort of lose the capacity to repair themselves normally. And what happens is you get changes in the cells in your lungs that lead to diseases like COPD. So I'm interested in learning more about what happens in these processes normally so that we can understand what happens when they go wrong. So I'm from just outside of Minneapolis, Minnesota. I went to college at Carleton College, and I majored in chemistry. After that, I decided I was more interested in biology, so my mom's a physician, so I've always sort of been interested in medicine. My dad's a chemical engineer, so I like to say that I sort of am a perfect blend between them. I study basically medical science, but using a lot of, you know, approaches that have to do with trying to understand how things happen or why. So I came to BU because I thought that Boston was going to be an amazing place to study science. There's a lot of opportunities here. So our lab is actually a lab that works on pluripotent stem cells. And what we use is basically we take these pluripotent stem cells and we take them through the stages of development. So, sorry, pluripotent stem cells are cells that can become any tissue type of the body. And so we take these cells, and what we try to do is to take them through different stages of development. So we push them to endoderm, which is where it's a germ layer, so there's three germ layers, and endoderm is where the liver comes from, the lungs come from. And so after that, we carry them through more developmental stages, and we make them into these lung cells, or cells that we think of as very early cells, like you would find in a developing baby, like a fetus. And then what I do is I take these cells and I try to figure out how we can drive them even farther to later cells in the lung. So one of the ways that we do this is by building systems where when the cells become, for instance, a lung cell, we have this whole system so that they turn green. So we have basically a protein inserted into the genome of these cells so that when they go through this whole process and now they know that they're lung, they'll turn on this protein and the cells will also turn green. So we can actually track them by eye. And see this process as it happens in the dish. When I was in high school, I didn't really know what, you know, scientists did. And sure, it's like, you know, there are scientists that exist, but you take science classes. It's not like taking a science class. It's not like memorizing the periodic table. That's not really, you know, what I do every day. What I do is ask questions and try to figure out the answers and try to learn something about the world. So I think, you know, if that's what you're excited about, you know, you could do it. It's great.